Insider Tina here once again from ShortMeTina.com with my daily recap. TGIF, TGIF, you made it. Today is Friday. The weekend is upon you. Congratulate yourself. Kick back, have a glass of wine, have, I don't know, a can, whatever it is that you do. Unwind. You deserve it. You've made it this far in the week. All right, so a couple of things to take note of. Take note that I'm actually doing this video before market closes. It's around 12:45 Eastern time. So I'm not quite sure exactly when this video will be uploaded and actually when you're going to see it. But take note that the prices that you're seeing may not be reflective of the closing price, because again, I'm doing the video prior to market close. All right. But before we get underway with our mission statement, yesterday I asked a question, not much participation, so I'm going to do it again. Let's see if we get more folks involved. Agree or disagree? I was perusing financial Twitter and I stumbled upon this comment, and again, it made me question whether or not this particular viewpoint or view is echoed amongst most retail traders. So I want to ask you, I'm curious to know what your opinion or your thoughts are on this subject matter. So what did that particular poster state? He stated, or she, stay away from the stock market. Do not trust the market, right? Do not trust it. Do not trust the market. Put your hard-earned money in a safe place. Essentially saying, don't put it in the stock market. So I am now asking, do you think the stock market is rigged? Question mark. Is the stock market rigged? Agree or disagree? Comment in the comment section. Before we get underway with our mission statement, let me welcome you. If this is your very first time tuning into a Short Me Tina video, I would like to say welcome. Do us a solid in the comment section right now. Let us know your name. Say hi. Tell me where you found us. Again, I generally say hi back. If you are returning, you know that I am forever grateful, because you can be doing so many things right now, but in this moment, at this time, right here, right now, you're choosing to spend it with me. How sweet. How incredibly sweet. So to you, I also say welcome back. Comment in the comment section. Let me know that you're returning. At this point, there's about maybe two handful of folks that generally comment. So I know who you are. Thank you again for always sticking with me. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for engaging. It means much to me. So to our mission statement, if you're new here, you might not know what we do here. So what are we about? Our mission is to build a powerhouse of successful traders. That's what we want to do. We want to turn you into successful traders, all the while helping you find more winners. Hence why we do these daily analysis and we recap whatever stocks are moving in the market. Why we're doing all this? Because we conclude if you win, if you learn how to trade, if you become profitable, then in turn that makes us look good and then we win. So if you win, we win. That is our mission here. For that to happen, I'll do what I need to do on my end. We'll do what we need to do on our end. You need to also get involved and participate. So let me know right now, what is your biggest frustration in reaching your trading goals? Again, comment in the comment section and I will link this video. I think it sets the tone. It sets the tone for exactly the lenses in which I view the stock market. I will link that video now. Again, it's 12 minutes in length. If you are new to trading, and when I say new, I mean if you've been trading for under 3 years, you're not seeing the level of profitability that you want, you're not seeing the level of success that you want, or you want to be more successful, ensure to watch this video. Again, it's under 12, or it's about 12 minutes in length, so not a great deal of your time being spent here, but I think it can transform essentially how you also look at the stock market, and I think it might do a lot for your P&L. So again, I'll link that video identifying what I believe to be the three pillars of successful trading. All right, so let's recap the overall markets. All right, we have the SPY, S&P 500 daily chart dating back to 2017. This black line is a 200-day moving average. Again, I don't generally trade indicators, but if there's any indicator that I do look at, it would be the moving average, in particular, the 200-day. At any rate, so good things for the SPY, right? As I indicated in several videos. So if you want to fact check that or verify that, then definitely head on over to either our YouTube page at ShortMeTina or ShortMeTina.com. Click on any one of my videos and you will hear me say, I think at some point the SPY can hit 300 within 2019. And that's exactly what happened. We went as high as 313 today, pulled back slightly, but right now we're trading over 300 and we're well above not only the 200-day moving average, but we're well above that resistance of 293 to 295. As long as we can stay above that, again, the market has been in a range. It's been range bound for about 2 years. We broke out. So for me, if we can stay above this particular resistance level of 293 to 295, the market can start trending. So while we saw 300 or while we're at 300 now, a trending market can get us all the way to 320, even potentially 350. I know this is outrageous, but follow price action. Follow price action. Bullish on the SPY. What else? IWM daily chart. Right now we're at 155.93. Went as high as, oh, this is very amazing. I'm surprised, right? Went as high as 156.17. But again, although we're above the 200-day moving average, again, we are above shorter-term support of 148 to 150. We are below that crucial level of 160, which is major resistance. Again, going all the way back to October of 2018, we have not, for the most part, traded above those levels. So for me, I don't know if the IWM is really in consolidation mode, like really, really tightening up that range to eventually break through in a very sort of, I don't know, in a very monstrous way, for lack of a better term. If that's what it's doing, great. But again, we need to be above 160. I'm not saying that it is acting bearish right now. Obviously not. We're above the 200-day. We're above shorter-term support. But we really need to get above 160. Again, considering that the SPY is making all-time highs. I didn't do the calculations, but I think the last time I checked, we were about 10% from all-time highs within the IWM. For me, that's way too much. So IWM, hopefully it gets going pretty soon. What else? Then we have Bitcoin. I generally start off with Bitcoin. I forgot to do it. Let's do it right now. Daily chart up about a little north of 2%. So we're trading in the 11,000s. Again, I think it's okay. Once again, we're above the 200-day moving average. We're also above long-term resistance of 10,000. That is now support. As I've indicated before, another asset class that is consolidating to some levels. So for me, if it can stay above 10,000, I cannot see why we will not revisit 13 to 14,000, but I'm giving it a time frame for that. I do not want us to be in this consolidation mode for too long. Not with Bitcoin. This is a fast moving, coin, so it should be moving fast. You see how we ran from April, a low of around 5,000, all the way to 14,000? Yes. So I want us to actually surpass 14,000. I want to say before we hit August. I don't care if we hang around there after August, but I want us to get above 14,000, because if we can do that, 20,000 is around the corner. My targets for 2019 at bare minimum 40,000, but I do see it at some point hitting 100,000, if not towards the end of 2019, perhaps beginning of 2020. What else? All right, and then there's ticker CRON, the marijuana space. I'm going to cover a few pot stocks following CRON. So it's off about north of 6% right now. I see a quote of $14.25. The low of the day clocked in at 14.11. Chances are we'll probably take out those lows. As you can see here, it is below the moving average, a 200-day moving average. I don't generally trade on moving averages, right? Because if I did trade on moving averages, chances are I would be very bearish on this stock now. And in fact, I'm not. I am just awaiting for a decent level to actually re-enter. I already have our zones for premium members, so we can get back into this stock, right? So let's recap a little bit. Let's play it out. When we initially got into the stock, it was around here back in 2018 when the stock was trading at around $5. We saw it quickly run up to around 20. What was the high? It says 23.96 here. I could have sworn it hit 25. I did, right. So it went up to as high as 25.10 before pulling back. So it's off something like 40 to 50% from the highs. It's okay. Remember what I said a long time ago. I haven't done a video in a while. I said I still see CRON as a $30 stock, and I mean it. But, you know, stocks do not go up in a straight line. any stock that moves from 5 to 25 in under a year, you're going to expect a really big pullback. It's to be expected. So waiting for that re-entry. Again, sitting here at 14.27, it's a little bit too expensive for me, but I still see this as a $30 stock. I do also see this declining a little bit further. What else? All right, and so another pot stock that is off about 7% or north of 7% on the day. I see a quote here of 34.56. This is actually another stock that we did really well with in the premium member community. Not CGC, but ticker WEED. At the time when we placed the trade, this was not listed yet on the New York Stock Exchange. So we actually bought the stock that was, or the company rather, at the time it was also listed on the Toronto Stock Exchange. So we bought Canopy Growth via ticker WEED versus CGC. But at any rate, I've maintained I am bullish in the long term on the marijuana sector, but you're going to expect your volatilities and your volatility. So also I want to note here to be mindful. I'm going to do some other, I'll recap a few other pot stocks. I think a total of four. So be mindful if you're invested in the marijuana space in terms of being overweight a particular sector. So while I like CRON, CGC, I'll do one in ACB. And I believe one other, you still want to be mindful, at least for me, right? You still want to be mindful that you're not over allocating to pot stocks. Why? Because clearly they're trading in concert, right? All the pot stocks are down now. So if you, are invested in about five different marijuana stocks and you have them all equal weighted around 10 to 15% of your portfolio, then your portfolio will it's going to be down right now because all the pot stocks are down. So that's just a little a side note there. So what do I think about CGC? Again, as I've stated before, do I see further decline? Of course. Right now it's off about 7%. I see a quote of 34.49. It went as low as, what was today's low? Today's low clocked in at 34.11. So I wouldn't be surprised to see it actually take that low out. I wouldn't say the writing is on the wall, but you should have noticed some trouble here when it broke support of around, we can say $39 to $40. And this support goes back to January of 2019. So for the beginning of the year, for the most part, we've traded above $39.40. When that level broke, you could say, you should have said to yourself, well, it seems as though it might drift a little bit further. But as I've indicated before, I still think the trade perhaps could be on the long side. I see a long opportunity setting up. So I'm actually bullish in the longer term on CDC, despite this 7% pullback. What else? All right, ACB daily chart, another pot stock that's off north of about 5% on the day. You can see it's below the 200-day moving average, hence perhaps why you're seeing this extreme sell-off here. Longer-term support clocks in at around, we can say, $4.80 to $5. Do I expect it to get there? Honestly, I'm not sure. There's a possibility that it can crash all the way there. And if it does, in my opinion, that would be a prime opportunity to buy. But even sitting here at 688, I do not think, from a not even from a risk-reward perspective, even sitting here at 688, I think the chart remains intact, in my opinion. What else? And then we have ticker APHA daily chart, again, off about 6% on the day. I see a quote of $6.19, the low clocked in at $6.14. Despite it being below the 200-day moving average, again, I like to trade really price action, just price. So based on that, looking here, longer-term support, you might actually get a bounce here if it dips to around $6. What else? And then we have ticker UUUU. Tongue twister, off about 33% on the day. I see a quote here of 202. The low clocks in for the day at 196. You can see it's actually approaching support. Not necessarily the best quality stock, but if you're looking for a speculative play, I would actually take it once, I would actually take the trade once it hits support of around, let's say 150. I think you'd get a nice bounce. What else? All right, and then you have ticker UEC daily chart. It's actually off about 27% on the day. I see a quote here of 104. The low clocks in at 102. This purple line here, you'd have to go far out, denotes support, which comes in around 90 to 95 cents. I suspect ticker UEC will drift towards there if you're looking to get into this stock. On the long side, I'd probably try to play that 90 cent bounce. If that cannot hold, then I think this is going to drift a whole lot further. So that's my take. Tina here once again from ShortMeTina.com. If you enjoyed any portion of this video, I'd like you to do three things for me. One, comment in the comment section. Do you think the stock market is rigged? What do you think about the pot? What do you think about pot stocks? Are you invested? Looking to get invested? Are you staying away? Let me know. SPY all-time highs 300. What do you think about that? Let me know. That's the first thing. Secondly, if you want more videos like this, ensure to head on over to our YouTube channel at ShortMeTina. Hit that subscribe button. Make sure notifications are turned on. I do videos Monday through Friday, but as today, they are uploaded at various times. If you never want to miss any, make sure that you are subscribed and notifications is turned on. And lastly, my friend, I have been trading for well over 15 years. If you think you can learn anything from me, then head on over to ShortMeTina.com. Sign up, become a member. Thank you for listening, and as always, thank you for the support, TGIF. Enjoy your weekend. I will talk to you on Monday. I don't care what they say about us anyway.